Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about order of operations with fractions. We've done order of operations before. I just want to do a few fraction problems. We want to do parentheses first, then exponents. We divide and multiply next, and then we add and subtract last. So a couple of examples. This one right here, 4/5 divided by 3, 4/25 divided by 3/5 is a division problem. Could be written this way, 4/25 divided by 3/5. That's the same problem, right? So all we would do is keep 4/25 the same, change the division to multiply, and find the reciprocal of the next term, which the reciprocal just means we're going to flip it. And so then I would say 5 goes into itself one time, and it goes into 25 five times. And if I multiply straight across, I'm going to get 4 times 1 on the top and 5 times 3 in the denominator for 4/15. Also, we could use our calculator to do that. And so I just want to show you how to use the TI-30XX. and so we're going to use this fraction button to make a fraction. So we're going to do 4, fraction button 25ths. And then divide, because that big division sign in the middle here, this is the division bar. And then we're going to do 3 fraction fifths. So that's saying on the calculator 4/25 divided by 3/5. And if I hit enter, I get 4/15, which is what we got here. If you wanted to use the calculator, the 36X Pro, which I happen to love, then we're going to use this fraction button. There's a couple different ways to use it. One, I can do 4 and then hit that fraction button. It automatically puts it into a fraction, 25ths. Now, on this one, to get out of that fraction, you need to use your arrow over button here on this silver round key up here. And that gets you out of that. Then we're going to hit divide. And then I'm going to do another fraction, 3 fraction fifths. You can hit that fraction key to start off with and then put the numerator denominator in. If you just put the numerator and then hit the fraction button, that works too. And then I hit equal and I get the 4/15. So you may have a different calculator, and if you don't know how to use your calculator, Google it. Just say I have a Hewlett Packard, you know, HP blah blah blah, or I have a Casio or whatever, and how do I divide fractions, and there's going to be a video showing you how to do it. So you don't have to have the same calculator I have. Okay. In number 2, we have a subtraction and we have exponents. Definitely exponents are going to happen before subtraction. 3 to the second power I know is 9. And 1/2 to the second power means 1/2 times 1/2. So that's 1 times 1 on the top and 2 times 2 on the bottom. So I have 9 minus 1/4. You can do that horizontally or vertically. Let's do it vertically. 9 minus 1/4. I didn't put the fraction under the 9 because I want to think about that a little differently. So I'm going to borrow from this 9. I'm going to make it 8, and I'm going to subtract. I'm going to take that 1 that I borrowed and make it 4/4. So what I have instead of 9 is 8 and 4/4. And now if I subtract 4 minus 1, I get 3/4 and then 8. So I took 1/4 away from 9. I have 8 and 3/4. That's a perfectly legitimate way to do that. Let's see what happens on the calculator when we do this problem. We don't have to put parentheses around this number, so 3 to the second power, I use that power button there on the left, minus, I'm going to put parentheses around the fraction. I don't really have to, but I'd like to you to get in the habit of making your entry into your calculator look like what you had so that you don't make a change that changes fundamentally the answer. So I have 1/2. And then I'm going to do the squared button there, too. So I've squared 3 squared minus 1/2 squared, and I hit enter, and I get 8 and 3/4. So wasn't that nice? It just does that right for us. Okay, that's a great way to check. It's good to practice your fractions on your own and then check it with your calculator. That's what I recommend. Okay, this one we have 3 halves minus 4/3, and the whole thing is to the third power. We have to simplify inside our fraction first. So I want to make sure that I'm going to take that to the third power. I'm going to find an LCD, which I'm going to call, say, is 6, because 2 and 3 both go into 6. So 3 times 2 is 6, so 3 times 3 is 9, and 2 times 3 is 6, so 2 times 4 is 8. So when I subtract on the top, I get 1 sixth, and now I'm taking 1 sixth to the third power. You can do that on your calculator easily. I'm just going to do the here, 1 sixth, and then in this calculator, I want to take that to the third power. I use that little X to the box. That tells me I can put whatever number I want in there. I want that to be a third power, and that gives me, you can't see that. It gives you 1 over 216. Where did that come from? Well, that's because it's actually 1 sixth times 1 sixth times 1 sixth. 6 times 6 times 6 is 216, and 1 times 1 times 1 is 1. Okay, evaluate this expression if we know x is 1 half, y is 2 thirds, and z is 1 fourth. Well, x is 1 half, y is 2 thirds. Now here, these two things are being multiplied, so I'm going to put those two things in parentheses to show that I'm multiplying them, 2 thirds and 1 fourth. Another way I could have written that expression is 1 half plus 2 thirds times 1 fourth, right? As long as I'm showing multiplication in some way, I'm okay. So I have addition and multiplication. I need to do the multiplication first. 2 goes into itself once, into 4 twice. And so I have 1 half plus 1 times 1 on the top, 2 times 3 on the bottom is 6. And then I can find a common denominator, which is 6. I can do this one vertically for you. If you're having trouble, the horizontal method. So I have 6. That one didn't change, but here it does, because it's 2 times 3 to get 6, so 1 times 3 to get 3. Remember, if you change the numerator, you change the denominator. When I add those together, I get 4 sixths, and of course I can reduce that because both of those could be divided by 2, and I could get 2 thirds. Now, I really want you to be able to do the common fractions in your head. I want you to be able to work with those without having to use a calculator. But order of operations with calculators, I am totally supporting your calculator use here. It's if I have 1 half, which is what x was, plus 2 thirds times 1 fourth. So I put that expression right into my calculator, hit enter, and it's giving me 2 thirds, which is what I got down here too. I know from that nice check on the calculator that I got that right. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.